Hi everyone, so below this video is the PDF file of my executive summary for you to take a deeper look into my report. Getting into it, the Google Merchandise Store is an easy-to-use site where users can choose from hundreds of Google apparel, toys, lifestyle products, and more for purchase. I assume that the target audience for this store site was early to late 20s men and women. After analyzing the data using Google Analytics, I discovered that over 45% of the users are between the ages of 25 and 34, and over 60% of users are men. My five key performance indicators that I focus on in this report are 1. Interest overview, 2. Behavior engagement, 3. Pages viewed per session, 4. Bounce rate, and 5. Conversions. To analyze my data, I started off by taking a look at the interest overview. From the month of October, I found that females 25 to 34 are most interested in value shopping, media, and entertainment, as well as the arts, theater, lifestyles, and hobbies. And the men 25 to 34 are most interested in value shopping, technology, and media and entertainment. Looking at the behavior engagement report, amongst these four specific audiences, there's proof that the target audience is engaged more than every other group. I compared the target audience to the second highest demographic group, which is males and females 18 to 24. The chart shows that the target audience is most engaged on the site, having the most sessions and visiting the most pages during those sessions. You can see on this chart how the pages viewed per session in the target audience are greater than the second largest demographic who uses the site. Within the target audience of males and females, 25 to 34, there's an overwhelming number more of sessions and pages viewed per session compared to the closest competing demographic. This specific graph shows that while the bounce rate of the males 25 to 34 is consistently lower than the bounce rate of all users, the bounce rate of females 25 to 34 is actually at times higher than all users, which means that the females of this age range are much less consistent than the men. However, when the data is averaged, the bounce rate of the females 25 to 34 is 43.74%, so right in that male bounce rate. As a merchandise store, it's critical to focus on conversion rates, specifically goal completions. The target audience goal completion is fairly higher compared to the second biggest demographic of users. In total, males and females of the 25 to 34 age group had 1,813 completions for the month of October in comparison to the 627 completions of males and females of the 18 to 24 age group. Now, diving into the insights, we'll start with the interest overview again. In this case, the site does a good job of captivating the target audience through products that reflect their interests. Scrolling through the store, there are a lot of well-labeled sales going on, and the products are all modern, as well as technologically driven with brands ranging from Google to Android to YouTube to fit that target market. After analyzing the data on engagement, it's clear to see that the target audience is most engaged across the site. This means that the merchandise store is doing well at drawing specific users in and enticing them to create multiple page views with each session. Pages viewed per session for the target audience is also showing successful results. The Google Merchandise Store provides a variety of options for their products. Having a number of options creates better site engagement across all users and draws in more from the target audience because they're products that interest them the most. The bounce rate is fairly average across the board. From analyzing the data, these bounce rates show that the site contains relevant content that reaches the needs of the viewers. Easy navigation through the site, quick loading time, and having just an overall clean layout helps the Google Merchandise Store maintain this average bounce rate. Compared to the average e-commerce site and their conversion rates, the Google Merchandise Store is a very successful site. They've made it very easy to continue to the checkout process of the transaction, which could be the reasoning behind such success. Now heading into my final section, which is where I'll be making my recommendations based off of the data I've collected and insights I've developed. My first recommendation is to improve the size options and stock of their products. I noticed while shopping around on the site, there's an abundance of options. However, once a product is selected, there are constantly limited size options. By having the ability to offer consumers the size they want, conversion rates could improve even more. The second recommendation I have is marketing the Google Merchandise site more. This site has a lot of great options and is very successful, but improving its marketing could grow their target audience as well as their engagement. Without any awareness that the site exists, it's difficult for organic searches to be generated from this. Placing even just a little bit more consideration on the store's marketing could grow the site's audience and increase goal completions. My third and final recommendation is rather minuscule, but it is to create a more dynamic display of the site. An addition of color and branding could give the site more traffic and even attract more of the 18 to 24-year-old demographic.